Welcome to this Quickstart video, where I'll show you the basics of using Soothe Live by oeksound. Soothe Live is a dynamic resonance suppressor that automatically detects resonances and applies suitable reduction. Let's jump right in. First, select the channel you want to insert Soothe Live on. Go to Plugins. Select whether you want to use a mono or stereo instance. Choose Dynamics or EQ. And select Soothe Live. This opens up the default preset, which has been carefully designed to fix harshness and muddiness in vocals and monophonic instruments. If you're happy with the results, then great, you're done. But if you need to adjust anything, let's explore Soothe Live's controls. Depth controls the general amount of processing. Soothe Live is level dependent, so always adjust depth according to your input source, even when using presets. More depth results in bigger cuts.
I'm a believer of the truth, cause I believe I got the juice. Yeah, I believe I got the juice, baby.
Each notch on the frequency graph represents a resonance being cut. You can see the reduction range in decibels on the right-hand side of the frequency graph.
The juice, baby.
Select the band and adjust its frequency until you find the resonances you want to cut. Raising a band means more reduction will be applied to that region. You can adjust the width by using a pinch gesture or by grabbing the region borders. Use multiple bands to target different regions. Delta is the difference between the wet and the dry signals, essentially showing you what Soothe Live is cutting out. Delta can only be toggled when the SXL is in config mode. Use Delta to hear what Soothe is reacting to during virtual sound checks or in-ear monitor mixing. We're using Delta in this video to demonstrate Soothe Live's functionality more clearly. Adjust detail to suit the sound source. Use fine detail for sharp and specific resonances and broad detail for addressing general energy buildups. A detail at around 3 to 7 works well for vocals and most instruments. Speed is the attack and release of the processing, ranging from fast to slow. A fast speed is good for aggressive cymbals and closed mic guitar cabs, while a slower speed is better for groups and master channels. A speed at around 2 to 5 is good for vocals and most instruments. Next, we'll exit the Delta mode. Bypass the processing using the internal bypass for a before and after comparison.
I'm a believer of the truth, cause I believe I got the juice. Yeah, I believe I got the juice, baby. Nowhere we need to run.
It's often a good idea to mix in some dry signal with the wet using the mix control. Try this. Crank up the depth so it's cutting a bit too much. Then turn down the mix to around 80%. Again, use bypass to compare. This blends in some of the unprocessed signal, which can be a useful way to get a more natural sound. If you're processing the signal a lot, making drastic cuts that lower the volume, you can use trim to regain that volume. Trim is the output compensation gain.
Nowhere we need to run.
And that's it for our Soothe Live Quick Start. We also have a more in-depth video where we delve deeper into the controls of Soothe Live with more examples. So make sure to check that out. Thank you so much for watching.
Hold me just hold.